Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Knaus Tabbert Group presentation together with CT11A. I will now guide you the next about 10 minutes through our group presentation and tell you more about our business case and the future perspectives of Knaus Tabbert Group. The first is, what is our mission? What is our DNA? We change the way people go on vacation. This means we offer, caravanning offers a maximum comfort and privacy, allows maximum freedom and flexibility, offers access to almost all holiday destinations and leisure activities, and can be optimally adapted to any lifestyle. This we do at Knaus Tabbert with our product range of 5 different brands, which serve all different kinds of models, ground floors, and vehicle types, which I will tell you later more in detail. Some facts about Knaus Tabbert in advance. Knaus Tabbert belongs to the top 3 manufacturers of leisure vehicles in Europe, and covering all market segments and all European segments. In 2021, the last full fiscal year in Europe, 260,000 vehicles were sold or registered. 26,000 was the total output of Knaus Tabbert last year. For this year, for the fiscal year 2022, we aim to achieve a total output of close to 30,000 units. Investments is a necessary cornerstone of our strategy. We're currently investing in the next years to come about 220 million in increasing the capacity to a total size of about 50,000 units to serve the market and the expected future growth of the caravanning market in Europe. 860 million euro was total sales we achieved last year, fiscal year 2021. To give you some information for the outlook, there's a slide later on also. For this year, we expect a total sales volume of more than 1 billion euros. 1.4 billion is the order backlog as of June 30. We're working with a constant order backlog the last 12 months, about 1.4 billion. And these 1.4 billion order backlog equal a number of units in the order book of around 35,000 vehicles, caravans and motorhomes. A few words about our product portfolio. As you see, we cover the entire range of models in the European market, caravans, van conversions, and motorhomes. And also from a price perspective, we cover all market segments from entry point with the brand TAP that we see as a unique cult brand with a price range of 12,000 to 20,000 euros. We also have with Tabbert a premium caravan brand and product. Here, the end of the is 70,000 euros, and these vehicles Tabbert is developed also for living all year or 12 months. Also winter, it is quite well and good. Van conversions, Weinsberg and Knaus from 50,000 to 80,000 euros, and motorhomes, Weinsberg and Knaus for the premium segment from 60,000 to 130,000. And which is also unique for a group like Knaus Tabbert, also compared to the listed peer group. We also have Morelo, which covers the luxury segment. And here the entry price is 200,000 euros up to 700,000 euros. And these prices are all list prices without any options and extras. Just to give you an idea, what is the, at the caravan salon 2 weeks ago, we sold a Morelo Grand Empire for 905,000 euros to a customer. Yeah, let's talk a little bit more about the fleet. As said before, we offer the entire range of models. You see here two caravans, the TAP and the Tabbert. The caravans were about 54% of total group revenue in the last fiscal year. The mid two pictures are so-called van conversions or camper vans, 26% of total sales last year. And on the right side, you see two types of motorhome. The one is so-called a semi-integrated motorhome, where we use the driver's cabin from the original OEM manufacturer, and a so-called fully integrated motorhome, where we only use the chassis, the frame, and the engine block, and the dashboard, and the entire housing is developed and made by Knaus Tabbert. And then the motorhomes were about also 20%, 25% last year. Some more illustrations you see also when we talk about the caravans, we see different product categories, starting with a compact version, a family version, which is also a double bed or a French bed, and including also bed for children for up to 6 people. Multi-purpose versions, they have a trunk door where they can also load your sports equipment like motorbikes or mountain bikes. And as I said before, the Tabbert is a luxury or premium caravan which is developed for 365 days living, also summer, winter, and all the other months of a year. And that's why it also gets expensive, because it is also different technical equipment. The motorhome market, or the van market, is here the van conversion or the camper van on the left side, and then followed by three images of motorhomes, alcoven, a niche market, a niche model, where you have four full bed spaces, two at the rear end and two on top of the cabin. The so-called semi-integrated versions, where we use the cabin of the OEM, and the integrated version, where we only use the frame and the engine block. And last but not least, Morelo, our luxury segment. You see here different model types. Here the difference between the premium segment and our luxury segment is that all these vehicles require a driving license, C is a truck driving license, where the others, the camper vans and the motorhomes, it is allowed to drive those vehicles with a passenger car driving license in Europe. These vehicles have a weight of up to more than 20 tons, and Morelo is in the European market the clear market leader with more than 50% market share. And what is the highlight here is, Morelo was founded almost 10 years ago. You see here also the chart on the right side, how the total sales in terms of units developed over the last 10 years. So in 2011, Morelo produced 74 units for the European market. In the last fiscal year, Morelo produced more than 500 units. And also here we see a significant market potential. Also, Morelo is planning in the next years with around 1,000 units output per year. When we talk about our product and strategy, Knaus Tabbert is not only a producer of vehicles, we also run our own rental system, our own rental platform named Rent and Travel. When we talk about what is the DNA, what is the strategy of Rent and Travel, we are not operating different rental stations like any other car rental company. What we do is we offer a booking platform. We connect our dealers, we connect interested customers to our rental platform, and we do all the aftermarket, the service, but the rental partner is a dealer, is a customer, is a private person. We only there offering the software. But also you see here why it is so important to offer such a system. This is a snapshot of just, we compare June 2020 with June 2021. The utilization of the fleet increased by over 20% to 72%. The total rent revenue generated by those platforms increased by 35%. The number of nights, the number of the trip duration increased to 40 nights or plus 27%. And also the rental price, what people are spending for renting a car, increased to 1,900 euros. The chart on the right down side here shows also why it is also from a strategic perspective so important, because the average customer is in the age of around 20 to 30 years. So very young customers, and these are the customers of tomorrow. People who cannot have the money to buy one, we give them a chance to rent it, to test it, to make the experience. I said before, what is the experience of caravanning? And we expect that the customer becomes, the rental customer of today becomes the buying customer of tomorrow, because the average age of a customer who buys a motorhome today is around 50 years. So we start at the very early stage to connect our customers, potential customer, with our group brands, Knaus, Weinsberger, Tabbert, give them the experience, support them at their journey, because we not only have the booking software, we also have a rent and travel app, which is more or less a digital travel guide also, and support our customers of tomorrow, give them the best experience for their vacation. Also important for sure is the production network. We operate four different plants. Three of them are dedicated to the premium segment, the brands Weinsberg, Tabbert, Knaus and Tab. The headquarter is in Jandelsbrunn in Lower Bavaria. We have one facility in Hungary and one in Motkos. Motkos is mainly for caravans, where the Jandelsbrunn facility in Nagyrosi is producing all different model types. And the fourth one is located in Schlüsselfeld. Schlüsselfeld is also the headquarter of Morelo. And in Schlüsselfeld, only Morelos are produced since the company was founded in 2010. Now it comes to the market. When we talked about trends, we talked about what is the driver for the industry for many years. You see different here topics, 7 bullet points. The one is aging population, younger customers, regional tourism, sharing economy and rental, new ecology, product enhancement, innovation and connectivity. And for sure, in days like this, also very important megatrends like the new work with caravans as they offer different smart devices, the required infrastructure. Also, our caravans and campervans are used today also for a working space and only a space for vacation. The market developed the last 10 years. When you see this chart here, since 2010-11, the market is in a constant upward trend. In 2021, 124,000 units were registered in Germany. Why this chart is for Germany? Because Germany is the most important market for leisure vehicles in Europe, and it is also the engine of the market for the entire European market. And also, as of today, we will see different scenarios or different crises, energy cost, and so on. Also, in days like this, we expect that the market will develop upward in the next years to come. This is also reflected by the success of the Caravan Salon 2 weeks ago, which was quite a success with more than 230,000 visitors. And also what we sold at the trade show, we see no real sign of a shrinking or declining market. The market is still in a good shape. What is unique when we talk about our peer group, our competition? What is unique for Knaus Tabbert? When you see here, this is the market share in Europe and the market share in the most important German market. On the left side, you see the market share for all our brands in the motorized leisure vehicle segment in Europe, which is represented by Knaus and Weinsberg. Both brands have a market share in the top 10 of the European market. When we only look about in the German market, see Weinsberg and Knaus is number 3 and 4. And this is again part of our strategy to have a very comprehensive product portfolio. There is no brand in our portfolio which is niche or has not its market share. And when we see at the right side the caravan segment in Europe or caravan segment in Germany, you see that Tabbert, Knaus and Weinsberg belong to the top players in both markets, in the caravan market in Germany and in the caravan market in Europe. And this is unique also compared to other companies in the industry, that they have no brands, no real portfolio in the top 10. When we now come to the order backlog, which is reflected also by the market development, you see that the last 12 months, Knaus Tabbert is operating with an order backlog of more than 1 billion euro of revenue. This equals to a size of about 30 to 35,000 units. Also, it depends on the model mix in the order book. And as of June, reporting date Q2 2022, we have an order backlog of 1.4 billion euro. And here, also to make a deep dive, you see that more than 70% of all these vehicles are motorized vehicles, camper vans and motorhomes, and only a few, about 20%, is caravans. And this also is the trend of the industry. The trend of the industry is more and more towards motorized vehicles, means camper vans and motorhomes. Also on the right side, you see also the order intake in the second quarter more than doubled compared to the first quarter, from 6,000 units to more than 12,000 units. So this means in the first 6 months of the current fiscal year, we gained more than 18,000 new orders for the model year 2023. Let me come back to the rental platform, Rent and Travel, and have here a chart about what is the strategy, why we entered the rental market about 5 years ago. It is our aim to connect the customer at the very early stage, as I said before, to our models, to our brands, Weinsberg, Knaus, all and foremost, and also Tabbert. Give them a chance to experience this kind of vacation, to experience our model fleet, our model mix, starting from small motorhomes to the big ones, from small campers to the big caravans. Connect them, service them, build a passion for caravanning, accompany the customer, the journey from renting to the buying process, and sell those vehicles finally either to the rental stations, because they also are growing, or sell it to the end customer. To give you some numbers here, today Rent and Travel is operating more than 2,000 different vehicles, via their retailers, via their dealer stations, and the total fleet of the top three players in the European market is close to 10,000 vehicles. I talked about the dealer network. Here I have also some illustration information how we are located in the set up in the European market. We have more than 500 dealers for the premium segment, more than 50 for Morelos. So in total, we have close to 600 dealers in Europe. And as you see on the right side here, we cover the entire European market with a focus for sure for the German market with close to 150 dealers, but also in the other most important markets like the Scandinavian countries, the Nordics, France and Spain, UK. We are quite well positioned to grow with the market and to serve the market in the best way. Innovation is key for the industry. Innovation is part of our DNA. We see ourselves as the innovation leader or the innovation driver of the market. What you see here is a completely new vehicle type, new for Knaus Tabbert, but also new for the European leisure vehicle market. What we did the last 6 months is we developed a car, a so-called Caravan utility vehicle. This is built up on a VW T6.1 platform, offering the entire range of equipment, starting from a kitchen, a bathroom, two beds. This is unique, and we see here a significant potential, not only for the customer, but also for the rental stations, because people want vehicles there which are easy to drive as they are used to with the passenger car. Second innovation we are working on now for more than 10 years is the so-called frame technology, a completely new production process, which gives also a chance to go more and more into automation. Here we first build the frame and then we can design and equip the Caravan with a completely new design and ground floor space. This is different to the past. In the past, the Caravan was built inside out. And with this new technology, we can, as I said before, go more into automation, design different floor spaces, and also go more and more into automation over the next years to come. And last but not least, electrification. Electrification is key for future business. Also linked to the automotive industry, we developed over the last 2 years a completely electric Caravan, but not only the full electric Caravan or the motorhome is very important for the industry, but also electric devices in the cabin. So we offer now for more than 2 years also so-called E-Power models, where we replace the completely gas installation by batteries or by accu bags to give the customer also auto key over more than 1 day. Chassis strategy, very important in the last 12 months or 2 years. When we talk about supply chain bottlenecks and so on, we decided in the last 12 months to go a new way to include more and more suppliers into our portfolio. But before we talk about these new customers and the strategy and what are the effects from that, is to just to show you what is a chassis for Knaus Tabbert. You see here on the left side a so-called chassis, including the cabin of the OEM for our so-called semi-integrated models. And on the right side, we see a frame or the chassis we purchase from a supplier when we talk about our integrated models. So this is a chassis. And here our chassis strategy changed last year. So we made a decision to leave our exclusive partnership with Fiat, with the Fiat Ducato, and start cooperations with almost all relevant suppliers from the industry. And as of today, we can say that we partner with 5 different OEMs. This means we have now Mercedes, Ford, Volkswagen, and MAN as 4 new relevant suppliers. When you see the pie chart in the middle, what is the effect just in the first 6 months? So we see that MAN becomes more and more important with about 22% of total production volume. Fiat reduced from 90% to about 74%, and also Mercedes is also already an important supplier with 4%. And when we go on the right side, what is the expected mix for 2022 total fiscal year? That the share of each of those customers becomes more and more important. And when we go now into future 2023 and beyond, we expect that Fiat becomes about less than 50% of the total volume. The remainder of this 50% will be shared by our new customers. But for sure, this means also when we talk about new customers, new chassis suppliers, it also requires new models built on new platforms. And here we did quite a good job the last 12 months. So we developed 16 new models on these new platforms. You see here 4 new models already launched at the Caravan Salon with the VW platform. There is another model to come, which will be launched at the trade show in Stuttgart next year. 2 new models with Ford, 1 to come actually in Stuttgart again. 2 different models built on the Mercedes Sprinter platform and 3 new models built on the MAN platform. And all this we did in the last 12 months, this is quite record-breaking. No other competitor, no other player in the market launched 16 models in one model year as we did. And this was not the end of the road. As said, there are more models to come in Stuttgart next year in January. Yeah, a few words about the historic financial development, 2029 to 2021. For sure, these years were impacted by the corona crisis and by supply chain issues. So here you see, if we went from 2019 from 780 million to 860 million around. And we expect for this year, for the fiscal year 2022, about 1 billion euro sales. Also, when we talk about earnings, you see also the earnings situation was impacted by 2 issues. The one is for sure supply chain impact. We increased the staff over the last 2 years by more than 1,000 people. Open up, these 1,000 people are required to fulfill all those orders. So we made the decision to keep those people also in times where we are not fully utilized in our factories, because we trained them. They are skilled workers and we know that we need them. And when we talk as of today, September 2022, this strategy gave us right, because today we see more and more utilization going up what's in our factories, as also this impacts the positive impact of our chassis strategy is improving. Yeah, let's come to the outlook 2022. What are we expecting for the current fiscal year? We expect a total revenue, total output of more than 1 billion euro sales and an EBITDA margin more than 6%. For sure, this more than 6% is still impacted by a weaker first half of the year, by cost from supply chain bottlenecks and also cost from having more people in the group than required, especially in the first half. But as a result of our new strategy in terms of purchasing of chassis, we will need those people in the next quarters and years to come. And so our long-term outlook or mid-term guidance is still valid and intact. This is also why we still are investing. When you see here an image of our plant in Jandelsbrunn, this facility is currently under construction. We launched a new assembly line in Hungary for camper vans, and also our facility in Düsseldorf for Morelo is invested the last year and is still investing into more capacity. So our midterm guidance we gave, this means until 2025, of a sales target of about 2 billion euro and total output per year of around 50,000 euros. We still are committed to this plan and investing for this. And all this means we have to fulfill some points. Yeah, it requires the right market environment. We see the market is still intact. We need future and competitive products. We have them. We need production sites and capacity. We are investing for this. We secure supply chains. We increase the number of chassis suppliers from 1 to 5 in the last 12 months. Train staff. We are committed to train staff. We kept them over the last 12 months, and the current way gives us proves us right. And financial resources. We launched a Schuldschein shown for 100 million. To finance the growth, we have increased our working capital facility, our syndicated loan, to 150 million. So to summarize the last 10 minutes, we are on a good way. We are on the right way, and we're committed to our plan. Thank you for your interest. And if you have any further questions, please contact me either by phone or by email. I'm available for you. Thank you.